Good evening and welcome to our service of evening prayer from St Michael's Chapel here in St Gabriel's Church, and we're using the Celtic format with one or two bits and pieces introduced. But to begin with, we're going to sing a hymn. Thought we'd go quite traditional tonight. There is one newer hymn in the middle, but to start with, we're going to sing Immortal, Invisible, God Only Wise, which you'll find if you're looking for it in the book. It's Songs of Fellowship number 234, or it's Hymns Old and New number 242, but the words are on the sheet.
Immortal, invisible, God only wise, in light inaccessible, hid from our eyes, most blessed, most glorious, the Ancient of Days, almighty, victorious, thy great name we praise. Unresting, unhasting, and silent as night, nor wanting, nor wasting, thou rulest in might. Thy justice like mountains, thy soaring above, thy clouds which are fountains of goodness and love. To all life thou givest, to both great and small, the true life of all. We blossom and flourish as leaves on the tree, and wither and perish, but nor change a thee. Great Father of glory, your Father of light, thine angels adore thee, all veiling their sight. All praise we would render, all help us to see, 'tis on thee the splendor.
Come to the blessing of the light, and I shall light our candles here in chapel and say the appropriate prayer, and then we shall sing Light of Gladness, Lord of Glory. The Lord is my light and my salvation. My God shall make my darkness to be bright. The light and peace of Jesus Christ be with you all. Blessed are you, Lord God, creator of day and night. To you be praise and glory forever. As darkness falls, you renew your promise to reveal among us the light of your presence. By the light of Christ, your living word, dispel the darkness of our hearts, that we may walk as children of light and sing your praise throughout the world. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Blessed be God forever. Light of gladness, Lord of glory, Jesus Christ, our King most holy, shine among us in your mercy. Earth and heaven join their hymn. Let us sing at songs descending, as we see the light
of evening. Father, Son, and Spirit praising with the holy seraphim. Son of God, through all the ages worthy of our holiest praises, yours the life that never ceases, light which never shall grow dim.
Let my prayer rise before you as incense, the lifting up of my hands as the evening sacrifice. O Lord, I call to you, come to me quickly, hear my voice when I cry to you. Set a watch before my mouth, O Lord, and guard the door of my lips. Let my prayer rise before you as incense, the lifting up of my hands as the evening sacrifice. Let not my heart incline to any evil thing. Let me not be occupied in wickedness with evildoers. But my eyes are turned to you, Lord God. In you I take refuge. Do not leave me defenceless. Let my prayer rise before you as incense, the lifting up of my hands as the evening sacrifice. That this evening may be holy, good and peaceful, let us pray with one heart and mind. As our evening prayer rises before you, O God, so may your mercy come down upon us to cleanse our hearts and set us free to sing your praise, now and forever. As we draw near to the place of at-one-ment, let us confess our sins. We say together, give us tears to see the wonder of your presence. Give us tears to see the wasting of your people. Give us tears to see the wounding of your Son. We are the race that helped to make the wood on which you were crucified, and still we misuse your creation. We are the race that helped to make the nails that pierced your body, yet still we use work for gain at others' expense. We are the race that did nothing to stop your betrayers, yet still we are ruled by comfort or cowardice. God, be gracious to us and bless us, and make your face to shine upon us. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. May your ways be known on the earth, your saving power among the nations. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, you have made known your salvation and revealed your justice in the sight of the nations. Lord, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. And Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Now, Chris, if you could unmute and read to us from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thank you.
Our Old Testament reading this evening on the second Sunday of Epiphany is found on page 714 on the Good News Bible. It is from the prophet Isaiah, chapter 49, verses 1-7. Israel, a light to the nations. Listen to me, distant nations, you people who live far away. Before I was born, the Lord chose me and appointed me to be his servant. He made my words as sharp as a sword. With his own hand, he protected me. Me like an arrow, sharp of use. he said to me, Israel, you aren't because of you.
Chris, I think the...
People will praise me, but have accomplished nothing.
Chris?
Yes, sorry?
I think it's just the internet is coming and going. You keep freezing on us. It's nothing. It's not your fault. It's just I think the internet's a little bit unstable. Would you mind just going back, perhaps and go back to verse 2 because we missed part of that when you read it before. Thank you.
He made my words as sharp as a sword. With his own hand, he protected me. He made me like an arrow, sharp and ready for use. He said to me, Israel, you are my servant. Because of you, people will praise me. I said, I have worked, but how hopeless it is. I have used up my strength, but have accomplished nothing. Yet I can trust the Lord to defend my cause. He will reward me for what I do. Before I was born, the Lord appointed me. He made me his servant to bring back his people, to bring back the scattered people of Israel. The Lord gives me honor. He is the source of my strength. The Lord said to me, I have a greater task for you, my servant. Not only will you restore to greatness the people of Israel who have survived, but I will also... make you an offering to the nations, so that all the world may be saved. Israel's holy God and Saviour says to deeply despised, who is hated by the nations and is the servant of rulers. Kings will cease and will rise to show their respect. Princes also will see it and they will bow low to honour you. This will happen because the Lord has chosen his servant. The Holy God of Israel keeps his promises. And this is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Thanks, Chris. Now let's sing, I, the Lord of Sea and Sky. It's number 830 in Songs of Fellowship, or number 235 in Hymns Old and New. I was watching Songs of Praise earlier with Lydia, and they did this song as part of the Songs of Praise today, so I thought we were extremely relevant and joining in with the theme for today. I, the Lord of sea and sky, I have heard my people cry. All who dwell in dark and sin, my hand will save. I who made the stars of night, I will make their darkness bright. I will speak my word to them, whom shall I save? The Lord of snow and rain, I have borne my people's pain. I have wept for love of them, they turn away. I will break their hearts of stone, give them hearts for love alone. I will If we can have the Acts of the Apostles reading, please.
Our second reading is on page 169 in the New Testament part of our Good News Bible. It is from the Acts of the Apostles, chapter 16, verse 11, 15. In Philippi, conversion of Lydia. We left by ship from Troas and sailed straight across to Samothrace and the next day to Neapolis. From there, we went inland to Philippi, a city of the first district of Macedonia. It is also a Roman colony. We spent several days there. On the Sabbath, we went out of the city to the riverside, where we thought there would be a place where Jews gathered for prayer there. One of those who heard us was Lydia from Thyatira, who was a dealer in purple cloth. She was a woman who worshipped God, and the Lord opened her mind to pay attention to what Paul was saying. After she and the people of her house had been baptized, she invited us, "Come and stay in my house if you have decided that I am a true believer in the Lord." And she persuaded us to go. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Thanks very much, Chris. Now let's say the Magnificat together, the Song of Mary. My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God, my Saviour. He has looked with favour on his lowly servant. From this day, all generations will call me blessed. The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. He has mercy on those who fear him from generation to generation. He has shown strength with his arm, and to scatter the proud in their conceit, casting down the mighty from their thrones and lifting up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things and sent the rich away empty. He has come to the aid of his servant Israel to remember his promise of mercy, the promise made to our ancestors, to Abraham and his children forever. Glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Let us pray. And first of all, let's say the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. And the collect of today and of this week. Almighty God, in Christ you make all things new. Transform the poverty of our nature by the riches of your grace, and in the renewal of our lives, make known your heavenly glory. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. And if you have the service sheet in front of you, perhaps you join with me in saying the evening collect. Lighten our darkness, Lord, we pray, and in your great mercy, defend us from all perils and dangers of this night, for the love of your only Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. We pray that Christ may be seen in the life of the Church. You have called us into the family of those who are the children of God. May our love for our brothers and sisters in Christ be strengthened by your grace. Lord, we think about the Church this week of prayer for Christian unity, which begins on Tuesday. And we're also asked specifically to pray for the Church of England, the Church in Nigeria, Johannesburg in South Africa, South Sudan and Sudan. And in our own Diocese of Chelmsford, the Deanery of Epping Forest and Ongar, the Reverend Lynn Cullins, the Bishop of Barking Elect, and the Right Reverend Guli Francis Dihwani, the Bishop of Chelmsford. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. You have called us to be a temple where the Holy Spirit can dwell. Give us clean hands and pure hearts, so that our lives will reflect your holiness. We pray, Lord, that we would be a witness to you in our community and in all the things that we do, that people would look to your church here in Pitsea-Witnevenden and see you. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. You have called us to be a light to the world, so that those in darkness come to you. May our lives shine as a witness to the saving grace you have given for all. Lord, we pray for the world, that world which is devastated by COVID-19, by terrorism, by natural disasters of volcanoes and tsunamis. Lord, we know that it's a mess, and we know that we cannot come out of it without your help. Give us strength, give us courage, give us faith to believe that you will help us if we call to you. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. You have called us to be members of your body, so that when one suffers, all suffer together. We ask for your comfort and healing power to bring hope to those in distress. And we pray especially for those on our prayer list on the notice sheet. And especially tonight, we pray for Betty, that she will be unaffected during her time of isolation and be fit and ready to go into hospital for her cataract operation. Similarly, we pray for Cheryl at St Peter's, that she would be unaffected during her period of isolation before going in for her knee replacement. And we pray for Pat Poole. Lord, she's still in hospital. We pray that you'd be close to her, and that you would fulfil her family's wishes of being able to bring her home so they can look after her. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. You have called us to be the bride where you, Lord, are the bridegroom. Prepare us for the wedding feast where we shall be united with you forever. We pray for the bereaved, especially those who have had to face Christmas alone this year, and all those who've been bereaved because of the pandemic. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And Jesus, Lord of the Church, you have called us into fellowship with all your saints. We unite our prayers with theirs and ask for grace to serve you with joy, where you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and for all eternity. Amen. And let's say the grace together. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen. Our next hymn is a modern hymn, Restore, O Lord, the Honour of Your Name. It's Songs of Fellowship number 483. Or Hymns Old and New, number 434. Meditations of all our hearts be now and always acceptable in your sight, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. The conversion of Lydia. You may have guessed from way before this time where we got the name for our daughter from this particular part of the Bible. It's a great story. Just to recap very slightly to the end of the previous chapter, Paul, the apostle with Silas, has been working his way through what's now Turkey. So he's been going through places like Asia Minor, places like Bithynia, places like Galatia, working his way through the interior. And he's finally arrived in Troas on the coast of Turkey. And of course, Troas is ancient Troy. Those of you that remember the stories about the Trojan War. And while he's there, he has a vision of a Macedonian, a Greek man, who says, "Help us, Paul, come over to our part of the world." Now, many people think that that vision, that man, was actually Luke, because Luke was a Greek person and a Greek-speaking believer. And of course, he wrote the journal of the Acts of the Apostles. He wrote up Paul's stories. And from the passage which Chris read to us tonight, it starts with we. Up until that point, it's they did this, they went there, they did that, Paul said this. Now it's we got in a boat. We travelled via Samothrace to Neapolis and we came to Philippi. So Luke is obviously on board and he's with Paul and the others. Anyway, they arrive in Philippi, mainland Greece, the first time that Paul has been onto the eastern part of Europe. And he's there and he wants to preach. Now, his usual pattern would be to go and find the synagogue and go and preach to the Jews there and tell them that Jesus is their Messiah. But in Philippi, there isn't a synagogue. So he's got to try and find out where the Jews are. And he goes to the riverside. Now, you might think, why on earth would he go there? Well, if you cast your mind back to when the Jews were in exile in Babylon, they gathered by the river. And one of the psalms that they used to sing reflected that. And of course, it was became a pop song by Boney M. By the rivers of Babylon, there we sat down and there we hung our harps. Now, of course, at that point, Paul knew that Jews without a synagogue would probably head to the river. And he was right, because that's where they were. Well, that's where the women were. I don't know where the men had gone, whether the men had all gone AWOL or they'd gone to watch the football or do something completely different. But the women were there praying. And one of them is a woman called Lydia. And officially, it says that she worshipped God. But in the original translation of the Bible, of course, she's officially described as a God-fearer. Now, God-fearers were those who wanted to worship Almighty God, but they weren't official Jews. If you remember, Jesus got into trouble in Jerusalem by clearing out the temple courtyard where the trading was going on. And of course, that particular part of it was called the Court of the Gentiles. The Holy of Holies, right at the heart of the temple, was where the high priest went once a year to offer atonement for the sins of the whole people. Then you had the Court of Priests, where the sacrificial altar was, where the seven-branch candlestick was. Then you had the Court of Israel, which was male Jews who could worship God there. Then you had the Court of Women, where the female Jews worship God, and outside that was the Court of the Gentiles, where God-fearers could go. Anyone who wanted to worship, the Lord who wasn't an official Jew. Obviously, you could get converted. You could become a Jew or a Jewess, if you so desired, by going through certain rituals to sign up. But at this point, Lydia is a seeker. She's a searcher. She believes in God and she wants to find out more. And it says that the Spirit opened her heart to listen to what Paul was saying. And of course, she became a Christian. And significantly, she invited the church, the embryonic church of Philippi, to meet in her house. Now, we've lived for years with this myth that women have no place in the Christian faith until 1994, when they were first ordained in the Church of England. Not true. Read the Acts of the Apostles and you will see that women feature quite highly in things that were going on. And Lydia was host to the first church that met on mainland Greece, and it met in her house. And the other significant thing is that Lydia happened to be in the right place at the right time to hear the word of God. Obviously, she was prompted to go and pray with the other women by the riverside, and she happened to be there on that day when Paul and the others came and told her the gospel of Jesus Christ, and she believed it. And she was baptized, and the whole of her household were baptized too. Now, she was obviously a woman of means. A dealer in purple cloth was somebody who had quite a lot of money, quite a lot of respect, because purple cloth was, of course, bought by the royalty and used by the aristocracy. So she had the means to be able to be a host for that very first church in Philippi. So let's pray that we will be in the right place at the right time when God calls us to do something, or when we just might be in that position to say one word or one phrase to somebody else which is really going to help them. it will make a massive amount of difference to the way that the gospel is transmitted, because we have that joy of knowing that Jesus died for our sins and rose to give us the gift of eternal life. Let's share it with the world. Amen. Now, that brings us on to our last hymn. We sang this outside St. Peter's today because Cheryl requested that we sang this evening hymn, "The Day Thou Gavest, Lord, Is Ended." So if you have the Order of Service, or if not, it's in Songs of Fellowship number 527, or Hymns Old and New number 475. Voice of prayer is never silent, nor dies the strain of praise away. And the sun that bids us rest is waking our brethren neath the western sky. In other words, wherever you are in the world, at any given moment, people are praying. And our Lord, wonderfully, our extraordinary Lord, is listening to every single prayer and responding to all that we do. May the road rise up to meet you. May the wind be always at your back. May the sun shine warm upon your face and the rains fall gently upon your fields. And until we meet again, may God hold you in the hollow of his hand. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you always. Amen.